up, everyone? This is Tatum. I'm back with another episode of Off the Wall. For those that's new to my channel, this is my segment where I like to go through my record collection and just show off, you know, my records. So today, I'm going to be talking about an album that's one of my favorite albums in a short amount of time it came out in. I think it's this artist's best album. And I just think, I really think it's a perfect album. I don't think it's a flaw on the album. So without further ado, today, I'm going to be discussing Pusha T, Daytona.
I want to talk to all you addicts out there that's got...
To me, I think it's Pusha T's best album. I think with the subject matter that Pusha T talks about, it sometimes is better to have, for lack of better words, the shorter songs as possible. Maybe 7 is too short for a lot of people. It's still clocked in around 20-something minutes. I think like 21 minutes to be exact. It was the first album released in the whole Wyoming Kanye producing albums, 7 album, whatever you want to call it, sessions. And it's like an ongoing joke that goes around the internet. It's like, you really going to listen? You think I'm going to listen to Pusha T talk about selling drugs and doing all this crime shit again for the 100,000th time? And that person be like, yes, I'm definitely here. I'm waiting for the new album as we speak. Hopefully it drops soon. Like, I need a new Pusha T album. Pusha T is one of my favorite rappers of all time. Like, he's in my top 10. The cover of the Whitney Houston bathroom, I know some people find it distasteful, and I can understand that, but I think along with the concept of it, of just like, it's two sides to each tale that Pusha T's life, right? He talks about being like a drug dealer a lot, and you know, and he makes it seem glamorous in most cases, but there is also a dark side of that world, and I think this cover like represents that. It's always another side to it. But I'm just gonna go over the songs. I usually do a few songs, but since it's 7, I'll just talk about them all, and yeah, just show a little love to Pusha T's Daytona. And it's also its 3-year anniversary, so perfect timing, right? Let's get into it. Daytona starts with If You Know, You Know. And I remember waiting for this album because it was the first one. Like, oh shit, Kanye's producing 5 albums, 7 tracks. Pusha T's first up. This shit has to be crazy. Like, because Kanye, he kind of fell back from his producing bag for a bit. You know what I mean? He was producing, but he wasn't as hands-on as he was in the past with certain artists and things of that nature. So to hear that he was producing a whole Pusha T album from start to finish is ridiculous. So I think If You Know, You Know was the perfect intro to the album. I think just to him start like rapping on, pulling up in that new toy, the wrist on that boy rock star like Pink Floyd, waving that rude boy, I'm aiming at you boy, ran off on the plug too like True Boy, imagine me do boy. Like, he was just going off, and then at the end, to bring it in to close out the verses, your numbers don't add up on the blow, that was 10 years ago, If You Know, You Know. And then with that sample, that beat is just hard, man. I think Daytona has some of the best Kanye production we've heard in years. I think him and Pusha T have a sound that is like this dark, grimy kind of sound that they kind of just mastered out as the Pusha T sound. Because to think about it, he comes from the Neptune sound, and yeah, Neptune's got some hard ass shit too, but for the most part, Neptune's have like it's always like a pop out of this element kind of beat, right? Like, even the old clip stuff, like, except for Grindr is just hard as fuck. With the Kanye and Pusha thing, it's just like, it's just a little bit more dark, and it's like an evil Pusha T to me. That's what it seems like. It brings out the evil in Pusha T. So If You Know, You Know was one of those great ones to start the record with. That goes into The Games We Play, which is probably my favorite song on here. Just that flip of that sample. Like, that fucking beat is just ridiculous. With Ye back chopping, the cars and the women come with options. Caviar faces remove the toxins. This ain't a wave or phase. Cause all that shit phased. This lifestyle's forever when you made. He said they talk about the length I made him wait. What the fuck you expect when a nigga got a cape and he's great? Ovens full of cake, steady bakes, still spreading pace. When love just accentuates the hate. This is for my bodybuilding clients moving weight. Just add water, stir it like a shake, man. To me, Pusha T doesn't have, I can't remember any bad Pusha T verses. And you could, in the comments, like, tell me a bad Pusha T verse, because I don't know any Pusha T bad verses in my Rolodex. But the games we play, it has one of my favorite lines too, but I'm going to say it before the end. I remember it was an interview with Pusha T when he was saying that, you know, he gave Kanye a playlist of just songs that he wanted the album to sound like. And, you know, some Raekwon stuff in there and Purple Tape shit in there. And I could hear just that grimy, classic hip hop feel for real. And like, it was just dope. Like, I can't really say anything else about it. Like, this album ended up on like a lot of top 10 lists at the end of the year. Like, this album was really good, and for the subject matter to be what it was and how it connected on a broader scale to a wider range of people is just crazy. Like, it's literally critically acclaimed. Hard Piano, and that's where the tingle with Tony Williams singing the hook and Rick Ross. I think Pusha T and Rick Ross make great collaborations. The one they had on My Name Is My Name was dope. I think Kanye did that beat as well. And this one, I think they just because they both are kind of like the same cloth of rapper. Like, their subject matter and themes are not that far off from each other. Their beats are not that far from each other, you know what I mean? And I remember Pusha T saying, like, you know, he had his verse and he felt like there's nothing more I could really say. And he said he sent it to Ross because Ross always gives you pretty much what you need when you ask for a feature. Like, everything's just always just right with Ross. Like, you don't really have to tell him to do anything else but just the subject matter. And you can tell it just sounds great. I think that beat is also crazy. Just, it's weird. Like, that sample is weird. I don't even know where he found it. It's, that hook is crazy. I heard like a demo version of this before, and like, it's nothing compared to this one that's on the actual album. But great record, man. 3 for 3 so far. Comeback Baby, that sample in there, and just to break it down to like boom, boom. That shit is just, dun, dun. And I heard Pusha T didn't even like that beat. Like, that shit's a no-brainer. Like, that's one of the best ones on the album. Dun, dun. Then to bring the sample back in. Never have I been locked up in a world of misery. Still fresh off the boat, niggas. Don't make me super soaked, niggas. Your life ends up a quote, nigga. The good die young, all dogs go to heaven. It's really just mama's falling out on a reverend. What? I'm glad in a time when he made this album, it was so much going on with the Drake shit, that through it all and all, everyone recognized how great this album was. You know what I mean? Like, the greatness of the album really didn't get lost. The greatness of the album really didn't get lost in the shuffle of all the bullshit that was going on in between it. And that just shows you how great the fucking album is in itself. So, fucking 2 thumbs up, Pusha T. Santeria. That with the, I don't know the original sample, but I know the Lil' Kim sample on Drugs on her first album. And just to flip that, bow, 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 bow. Like, that shit was dope. And to have, I think it's Shake come in and sing the hook, but when the beat switches and it goes into like this RZA kind of Wu-Tang-ish kind of beat, oh my gosh, like that. To be only 7 songs and to not, I don't think it's a miss on here. I know some people might, I don't know what people would call a miss on this album. I really don't. It's just crazy. Like, it was really, it's really, really perfect. And then he's talking about his, I guess, one of his friends who passed away. And his name is My Name. So every time I hear him, he's like, yeah, you're listening, Davon? I'm like, I think I am. Into What Would Meek Do? And I think this is probably a song that people might, if they say it was a fumble, it would be on this song. But I like this song. I like the beat. I love niggas talking shit, push, how do you respond? I'm top 5 and all of them die long. I am the hope, the dope dealers want. The price and the quote, the dope dealers want. Feds taking pictures like it's GQ. Angel on my shoulder, what should we do? Devil on the other, what would Meek do? Papa Willie, tell the judge to Akinelli. Middle fingers out the ghost, screaming Machiavelli. Hail Mary, the scale fairy. 2 sides to every coin, so we bail ready. Man, get the fuck out of here. And I think Ye's verse was great too. I just think, in the midst of all the shit that he was doing and in the middle of at the time, people just would tune out to Kanye. They really didn't want to hear anything on it. But I think he was spitting on it. What he says, it won't feel right till I feel like Phil Knight. Going for 6 rings like with Phil told Mike. 7 pill nights. Who know what that feel like? No more hiding the scars. I show him like Seal, right? How do you respond? Like, that was just dope. And then he closes out with Infrared, which Infrared is just like a bomb. Infrared is just a bomb. Like, that beat is so menacing. It's, every time I see it, I feel like somebody's walking up in like red background, hoodies on. It's just in slow motion. Hype Williams should have did a video for that, like Belly Style. That would have been dope. They should have got Hype Williams to do a video for Infrared, but I understand why not. That song was just the perfect way to close the album for me, because it kind of like, we all know what niggas for real been waiting on, Push. And then like, it goes off eerie, like Kanye's chopping up this sample. I'm gone, you hear me? I'm gone. Like, oh my gosh. And then not to just mention, okay, I'm like a diehard Lil Wayne fan. He's in my top 10 as well. And the way Pusha T is just, because I think Wayne caught the worst of Infrared than Drake. I think Drake, you know, he gets the You Ain't Write Your Songs and, you know, things of that nature. But Wayne got the real heat. Like he said, salute Ross because the message was pure. He see what I see when you see Wayne on tour. Flash without the fire. Another multi-platinum rapper trapping can't retire. Niggas get exposed. I see the cracks and I'm a liar. Shit, I've been exposed. I took the crack and built the wire. Now who are you, Maya? It's like, oh my gosh. Another multi-platinum rapper trapping can't retire. Gosh. He see what I see when you see Wayne on tour. And then to have all that information with him and Baby come out. And I think that's the worst. That's the worst part of the whole thing right there. Like, that's just, yeah, that's just nuts. But that started the whole fucking, then W Freestyle, and then Story added on, or whatever the shit's name. And, you know, but I think it was just a great closeout record for the album. It's on some hip-hop shit. I said what I had to say. Yeah, Infrared. Like, it's just great. Let me get into my best songs. Games We Play, Comeback Baby, Infrared. Yeah. Worst song, what would Meek do? I'll say that one. Best line, he says, stay woke, niggas, or get out. Still bring the whips out. Still spread the chips out. Might buy your bitch some new hips and yank a rib out. The message in this music, all my niggas had to live out. Nigga said, I might buy some hips for your bitch and yank a rib out. Yeah, that's my favorite line on it. Let's wrap this shit up, though. In closing, Daytona, again, is one of my favorite albums of all time. And I know it's only been 3 years, but I think it's a perfect album. Those 7 records are ridiculous. Even with the Drake diss, the greatness of the album didn't get lost in the Drake shenanigans and shit. I'm happy that it's just recognized as a great album. I think everything's perfect about it. The beats, the rhymes, the metaphors, the everything. Like, it's just perfect. It's what you want from Pusha T. It's just dope, for no pun intended. And I'm waiting for the new Pusha T album, half produced by Neptunes, half produced by Kanye. That should be fucking amazing. Drop the fucking album. As always, though, thanks for tuning in. It's time for me to put this record back on my wall. Peace.